First of all, I'd like to welcome everyone. My name is Dan Klein. I'm the Executive Director at Habitat of Northwest Indiana. And we're here today with a lot of partners. Some you'll meet along the way. But let's start off with an opening devotion from Rosanna.
Rosanna, come in.
That's not on, is
no,
it?
It's recording.
Oh, okay. I am glad to see you all here today. And one of the things, I'll have a brief prayer, but I wanted to base it on a part of Ephesians where it said, you are no longer strangers to God, but you are members of God's own family. And it goes on to talk about the cornerstone and the dwelling place. And if we could have a quick word of prayer then. Our Heavenly Father, we come to you today with joy in our hearts. We're going to be able to build another home that is a God-built house. We will have many hands and hearts entering into this building and opening the doors to Habitat Home in another community. We thank you for today and all the goodness you have shown us. We thank you for leading us to Camisha and finding that she could partner with us in our own Christian ministry in Northwest Indiana. Be with Camisha and her family, as well as with all of us, as we minister together in doing your work. Be with us as we take each step in the building of this home together. May it be a true blessing, not only for our Northwest Indiana Habitat, but also for this new partner family and also for the city of East Chicago. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Rosanna. Rosanna is co-chair of our Family Selection Committee. We're glad to have her with us today. Next, I'd like to ask Dave Baker from our Executive Committee to say a few words. David?
Sure. Hello, everyone. Great day for the City of East Chicago. A new project together, a new partnership. We have Mattel Steel, we have the City of East Chicago, and Habitat for Humanity working together to help help families' dreams come true in East Chicago. I'd like to give special thanks to the City of East Chicago, Mayor Copeland and his staff, for supporting this program and helping it go forward. Of course, Mattel Steel for their generous contribution to make this possible. Without the city and without Mattel and their generous contribution to the community, this would not be possible today. I'd also like to thank Dan Klein, the Executive Director of Habitat for Humanity, and his staff, many of people who are here today, who worked very hard. Many have given many volunteer hours to make this project a reality and to make dreams come true. On a personal level, I grew up in Indiana Harbor. Went to Washington High School, drove my bike up and down these streets. It was a great place to grow up. It still is a great place. I think all we need to do is give people the opportunity to have a decent place to live and also to help their dreams come true. Thank you, and let's build a house.
Thank you, David. John, you want to make a few remarks on behalf of the city? Please.
Good morning, everyone. This truly is a great day in the City of East Chicago, for we're going to be embarking upon the building of the second Habitat for Humanity house in the City of East Chicago, the first one being done about 20 years ago. So there's a bit of a lapse between the first and what we're attempting to do right now. And we're looking for forward to many more partnerships, if you will, on housing units that will be developed in the City of East Chicago for worthy people such as Ms. Cast. The city has been grateful for the opportunity to work with Habitat and its staff, and I'd like to point out two key people at the Department of Redevelopment that have been instrumental in getting us to this particular point, and that's Nicholas Smith and Levette Turk, who's our programs manager for the Department of Redevelopment. They deserve a lot of credit for what's happening now in terms of working with your organization to get this to come to pass. And so we're grateful for the interest, and we're grateful for the service to our community, and we look forward to building upon this in the near term. Thank you.
Thank you, John, for all the help, and Levette and William for all the help that you guys have given us. We look forward to working together for a long while. At this point, I'd like to recognize a few people, one of them being the architect of the house, Mr. Jim Kyleman, and one of his employees who helped start the plans on his own, to volunteer his time to put the plans together for Camisha. Thank you. Wait, thank you. And then also, I want to introduce another partner, another board member of ours, Mr. Tony Gregory, who's with the Civil Engineering Department at Purdue University Calumet. Tony? If you could tell them a little bit about what you've helped on the house, how you helped.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm the department head of Construction Science and Organizational Leadership at Purdue Calumet, and one of our programs is Construction Management Engineering Technologies. And Purdue Cal has a requirement now that all their students that graduate with a four-year degree have to have a certain amount of what they call experiential learning. And that means that what you do in the classroom has to reach out and touch with some community partners. And we've had a community partnership with Habitat for years, and it was more unofficial than it is right now. But basically how that worked into this project is that students from one of our architectural technology classes built the walls for this house. In fact, the walls are all built and they're stacked up in our lab on campus waiting to be hauled out here. So it's a nice partnership. The students get a hand not only in some experience for construction, but also they get to work from a community partnership standpoint. So we're really proud to be a part of this. Thank you.
Thank you, Tony. A couple other people I'd like to recognize: our general contractor, Dean Jones from Arar Development, and our volunteer crew leader, Larry Counts, he's with Cargill. Thank you. Next, I'd like to introduce Lois Wilkins, who is our co-chair of our family selection, to introduce our new partner family. Lois?
Good afternoon, and what a wonderful day this is. Mayor Copeland, Habitat Board, volunteers, committee members, and distinguished guests, welcome. My name is Lois Wilkins. I am the co-chair of the Family Selection Committee, along with Rosanna, who did our prayer earlier. We are delighted you could be here today to help us break ground for our newest partner family. This year, Northwest Indiana Habitat for Humanity will celebrate 25 years of building homes in Northwest Indiana. Throughout our planning and preparation during this two-year process for Camisha's home, we were strengthened by Habitat for Humanity's international mission statement. Habitat for Humanity works in partnership with God and people everywhere, from all walks of life, to develop communities with people in need by building and renovating houses so that there are decent houses and decent communities in which every person can experience God's love and can live and grow into all that God intends. Today marks a wonderful day, as home ownership is the cornerstone of Northwest Indiana Habitat for Humanity and the American Dream. We are proud to break ground for Camisha Cast and her daughter Kayla's new home. Camisha has worked at Calumet Township Trustee's office for 6 years, and she is currently pursuing her master's at Indiana Wesleyan University. It is with great honor and pleasure to introduce to you Camisha Cast.
I'd just like to first thank God for allowing me this blessing through Habitat for Humanity. I'd like to thank Habitat for Humanity, all of the volunteers and staff, for all of the long work and hard hours that you put in to get me to this point. Me and my daughter greatly appreciate it. I'd like to thank the sponsors and anybody else that I've forgotten, all the crew, the architects, everyone. I'd just like to thank you, and I just look so forward to my house being built.
Thank you, Camisha. Glad that we're going to be working together shortly. At this point, I would like to keep introducing people because there's so many. We're honored to have so many board members present today, and there's two that I did not introduce yet: Bob Groh and Bob Johnson. And I think that covers the board that was able to be here. So, with this, I would like to have the official groundbreaking. If we can have Camisha and John. You guys want to turn the dirt? All right. It's got a basement.
I have to say that John Artis mentioned the other house, and that was a long time ago. I've been with the group of our Northwest affiliates these 25 years, and I believe it was one of the churches, if I'm not mistaken, in East Chicago that really was responsible for that one. But at any rate, we are certainly blessed and happy today that things have worked out and we're going to have this one this time. And with that, there is in the Psalms something about rejoicing with the Lord. And it says, let all the joys of the godly well up in praises to the Lord, for it is right to praise him. Play joyous melodies of praise upon the lyre and on the harp, and compose new songs of praise to him, accompanied by skillfully on the harp, and sing joyfully. And with that, we'll close. Dear God, be with each of us as we leave today. Guide and direct our lives as you would see fit. Guide those hands and hearts as they build another of your homes for your people. Let each step be a labor of love for you as well as for each other, no matter what walks of life we may come from. We ask this in your name. Amen.
Thank you, Rosanna. I want to close with these few words. Habitat for Humanity is the sixth largest home builder in the United States this year. We have built 54 houses in Northwest Indiana. This will be our 55th. And we have paid for 29 houses internationally out of our Northwest Indiana Habitat in the last 25 years. So we're proud to be here. Again, thank you all for coming. Thank you for the partnering with Habitat of Northwest Indiana. Have a great afternoon.
Let me start off East Chicago by saying that we are truly blessed. We're here today with Habitat from the Humanities. They're here to put this project together in the 40th block of Cary. We're looking at, is it four? Four homes in its completion? Three? No, they're going to start with one, but it's going to culminate into three, possibly four homes here. It's the first link into the revitalization of this community here. You can see behind me, we have Jackson Park that from these houses, you will be able to access the park. I mean, kids will be able to literally leave out of their backyard and run, cross over to the park. Today, I would say the temperature is maybe 95 if you're standing in the direct sun, but I would say that temperature pales in comparison to the heat that's coming off of this project because of the potential that can be generated from this project is enormous. This will show us the potential of the community stepping up benefit. It will show us private industry stepping up. It will show us the height of volunteerism. And again, it will show us an agency, the Habitat for the Humanities, that have a track record bar none, have a heart bigger than the sun. This is just win-win all the way around for our community. I am truly blessed to stand here in their presence. And let's say this is the beginning and the start of something beautiful, East Chicago.
Ray Flores for ECTV alongside Camisha Cast. Habitat for Humanity are building their second home in 20 years here in the city of East Chicago. Camisha Cast is the recipient of that second home. Camisha, give me your thoughts on this historic day here in the city of East Chicago, one that I know will live in your memory for quite some time.
I just like to thank God for providing me this opportunity to partner with Habitat for Humanity, and I so look forward to my new home being built.
Tell us what went through your mind when they called you up and let you know that you were going to be the recipient of this Habitat for Humanity home here in the city of East Chicago.
The process has been lengthy, so when they called me and said that they were breaking ground, it was, oh, thank God, it's finally here.
What are you looking forward to most?
Being stable again, not being a boarder at someone's home, because we moved out of the previous apartment thinking that it would be built in a few months, but due to some technical difficulties, we've been a little bit longer than normal at someone else's house. So that's the most valuable part of it, being stable, having my own place all over again.
Camisha, good luck and congratulations.
Thank
we look forward
you.
To seeing you in
Thank
your new
you
home.
Thank you so much.
Camisha Cast joining us here on ECTV.
Thank you.